Hello everyone, let us see how to monitor log files in Zabbix today. So we have to click on configuration templates and then click on create template, and then let us give a name to it, call it as log underscore monitoring. And then we'll have to add this to a particular group. Say for example, I have created a group and I'm just adding that template, that particular group. Now we'll have to go back and search for that particular template. Let us say log underscore monitoring, and then we can get the name, click on it. A very good way is to first create or associate this particular thing with an application. So let us create an application and call this as my underscore log, so that we can easily segregate the monitoring. And then let us click on items here, click on create item. Then we can give any name to it. Say let us give it as log underscore one. Very important thing is the type has to be Zabbix agent active. It is very important. Now for the key, we have to give the syntax as log, and then open bracket. We have to give the path here. Let us create a folder in slash temp, and then we will copy one of the file into it. Let us create a folder under temp rather than directly copying. It is a password, so let's say mkdir log. Now when I do a pwd, we get as temp log. Now let us copy the etc password into the slash temp slash log, so that we can directly start monitoring this particular file. We can monitor any file for that matter. That is, for the simplicity, I'm just taking the etc password. We'll do a little, we can find that. Okay, now let us copy the slash temp slash log and slash password and enter into the Zabbix. The syntax is quite simple. After writing log, open square bracket, put the log file name, put a comma, and then we will put what is the word that we need to find. So for that, we'll just do a cat of this password file, where, and we can see that there is a word called shutdown. So any log file for that matter will have something like shutdown, critical, failed, warning. So we can use any of this. So the logic is similar. So we do a grep after getting the password file. We are able to see the word shutdown. So let us put that in the key parameter, and then we will close the bracket. And very important thing is the next one, and type of information we are going to select as log. It is very, very important. We should not keep it as numeric. And then update interval, we can keep it as 5 minutes as usual, but for simplicity and ease of getting it, let us keep it as 10 seconds. And then important is select the application that we created earlier. Now let us click on add and then save the template. After saving the template, we will have to deploy this particular template onto the server. So let us deploy this particular template onto the Zabbix server itself. So let us search the Zabbix server and then click on it, go to the template tab, and then let us associate the template called as log underscore monitoring and then click on update. So once this is done, let us go to the update data, and then we'll search the name as log and then click on apply. We'll be able to see the application my underscore logs as well as our item called as log one. If we go back to the template, we can see that we had created an application called as my underscore logs, and then we had created our item as log1. So if you just wait for a few moments for it to go and fetch the data, then we can see that that particular log file would be read, and it'll check for that pattern, and then once it is found, it'll be able to populate in the latest data. So let's click on apply. Yeah, there we can see the word shutdown and whatever there in that line has been captured successfully. So we click on history, we'll be able to see the entire data of what is captured at what time. So this is a very important way of monitoring the log files in Zabbix. Now let us create another log file, say call it as log2, and then Zabbix agent active, and then the key starts with log, open the bracket, then we can give an effect. Say for example, I'm giving it etc hosts. I mean, this is not a valid log file, but I'm just giving an example, and then we can write the word as fail or critical or warning, whatever. It's as straightforward and simple as this. And we can also start monitoring the log file monitoring on the Windows machine also in a very similar way. So we can give the log bracket and then the application. Say for example, it's an application log. In the application, we have certain things that we need to monitor. We can write the log file name and then put a comma and then put the keyword that we need to monitor, say critical. Or say for example, we have a certain log file, say for example, if it is in a C drive, then accordingly we can give the path as C:// there is a folder under it called as ABC, and inside that there is a file called xyz.log, and then we have to monitor a certain keyword. We can just give it like this. So it is as simple as this, guys. Or in the next. Cheers.